Now, he's an aviation professor at Sacramento City College, and he's also a pilot, so he has decades of experience in the industry. And he says that an aviation accident investigation can essentially be broken down into two parts, finding out the what and finding out the why. He says that this preliminary report released by the NTSB is the first part of the investigation and answers the question of what happened.
First CHP on scene, they're getting a report of a helicopter crash on eastbound 50.
On October 6th, a Breach medical helicopter crashed onto Highway 50. On board were three crew members, including nurse Susan Susie Smith, who died 4 days after the crash. Pilot Chad Millward and Margaret Davis both have been released from the hospital and are now recovering at inpatient rehabilitation facilities, according to Reach.
We're getting reports that it's eastbound 50 west of 59.
Almost a month later, we're learning more details into what happened.
That helicopter came down 1,000 feet from my front door. I live in that neighborhood.
Scott Miller is an aviation professor and a pilot with decades of experience in the industry. He provided insight on the NTSB preliminary report into the investigation.
Confirmed what I had initially thought had occurred, which was a major power failure and then the helicopter having to auto-rotate down to the freeway.
According to the federal report, the helicopter had just departed from UC Davis Medical Center Tower. It was in the air for a short amount of time before the crash. The report also notes that the flight paramedic noticed the power had gone out and the helicopter was auto-rotating towards Highway 50. She then made a mayday call.
Utilizing the paramedic to make the actual radio call, I thought was pretty good.
According to the NTSB report, the outer portion of the main rotor blade was discovered embedded in the roof of the garage of a home near the freeway.
Those rotors have a lot of force and inertia built, and when they come apart like that, they come apart with great force, embedding it into the side of that garage in my neighbor's house.
There's still several unknowns surrounding the investigation. Miller says that includes finding out the why.
I think it's going to end up being some sort of major mechanical failure inside the engine that possibly was missed on an inspection, or maybe wasn't even apparent on a routine inspection. The helicopter had been working great. I don't mean to trivialize it, but sometimes things just go wrong.
And again, these are all preliminary findings, so there may be more details that come out as the agency continues their investigation. Live in Sacramento, covering local news that matters, Kimberly Cruz, Fox 40 News.